Empires of storage units to hold our unnecessary stuff. A fortress of moth-eaten memories, guarded with whimsical boundaries. A providence for buying things we crave but really do not need. The materials to which we cling that we think will bring happiness. Generations addicted to television and other mind-numbing distractions keep us focused on brainwashing remedies to pessimistically veto individuality. Acquire our thoughts and mindsets from celebrities or preachers, politicians, and quacks whose regimes we follow religiously to avoid the stress of formulating our own thoughts. It's hip to be cynical, assume the worst right from the start. Pass judgments on things we know nothing about or have obtained only first impressions. People are easy to consume and discard, the result of McDonaldization. Nearly nothing in this world is sacred anymore, just gets used, thrown away, fully wasted. Importance only the future and achieving a lucrative job. Start planning your life back in middle school. Choose your way of reaching the money. Strive for deadlines, paydays, and release dates, and simply tolerate the present. It all won't come fast enough, so just rush through your life. If you're bored, just watch more TV. Dictators are our own bodies. Our physical assets define who we are, especially if we're fat or ugly. Our skin pigments, especially vital as well, skin tone apparently describes personality. Let's get skeptical if someone's not beautiful. Actions discredited by their own bodies. Nothing's enough, everything's never enough. Greed has manifested gratitude. The paradigm's stuck on the external things, and thinking of oneself is most important. Shallow's the fashion, self-obsession the fad, and everything seems quite hopeless. But if we first work on rearranging ourselves and directly start fighting the feed, we'd have more individual unity. All without committing mutiny, we could achieve a state influenced by love and peacefully destroy this empire.